Hello, YouTube fans. It's been a while. I put out part one of my first Todsla road trip, and now it's time for part two. And you might see that I got some superstitions going here, or fandom, because I need the Golden Knights to not blow another 3-1 lead. They play tomorrow night. It's Thursday. This video posts tonight. They play tomorrow night, game 7 against the Wild. That's what you call a sigh of stress. We also blew that series with a 3-1 lead. Anyways, let's pick it up with part two. If you saw part one, if you didn't see part one, go back and watch part one. This is part two. And we leave off where we're leaving Las Vegas for the next leg of our tour, which again, I think I repeat 20 times in the video, but we're headed to Twin Falls, Idaho, and then eventually to Lake Tahoe. Enjoy. All right, it's Friday morning. We're checking out of the Mandalay Bay. We're already on the road. Our next stop is heading to Twin Falls, Idaho. Of course, we're gonna stop for some charging spots, so we'll see how the efficiency's going. Right now, we're headed to the best coffee in Las Vegas. If you're in Vegas, hit up Bad Owl. It's a Harry Potter theme, but their coffee is amazing. Try the Nutella blended.
Try the Nutella blended.
Or the roasted almond latte. Has crushed almonds inside of it. Headed there now, and then we're gonna charge up and hit the road. It's very windy, but I just need to tell you, through all this wind, this is the spot. This is the Nutella blended right here. Come here. And when you're in Vegas, it's right off the strip, kinda up on Rainbow. It's really loud here, but come to Bad Owl. It's the best. You won't regret it. All right, we are leaving Las Vegas, and destination again is Twin Falls, Idaho. And the map is telling us we will stop in St. George. And we'll get there with about 34% battery. And that's the first of three charges, maybe four, because I'll probably have to charge it up to a good amount in Twin Falls before I get to my brother's house. So here we go. Long journey ahead, probably 11 hours in the car. It's gonna be a fun one. Here we are in the middle of nowhere, doing a little enhanced autopilot, long stretches of straight road, long stretches. So this really helps a great deal. Still about 76 miles from our first charging stop on this leg of the trip. And now it says we'll get there with 33% in St. George. As you can see, it's just nothing but desert. Good old Nevada. Approaching our first charging spot off of Bluff Street here in St. George. And I am arriving with 27%. Charging up here in St. George, where they have six chargers. And yes, I'm doubled up because that car just left over there. It's been a good drive so far. By the way, if you ever want to test the performance of your Tesla, take it from Vegas to St. George. The Virgin River, whatever they call it, the turns for like 5 to 10 miles is amazing. And you can put the car to the test, and it holds up well.
Here comes Speed Racer, he's a demon on wheels.
I always wanted to do that drive in my Camaro, but I never did it, but it was fun to do it today in the Tesla, rolling with the performance model, but also the unplugged performance springs, sway bars and camber kit and upper and lower control arms. It really felt nice.
Go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go Speed Racer, go!
If you're ever up this way, down this way, up this way, wherever you're from, give that drive a drive, you're gonna love it. One thing cool about Utah is, check out the speed limit. Yeah, buddy. You can get up to 80 here, legally. And maybe within 7 or 8, if the cop is not being a jerk.
Wide open roads.
Oh, this is fun. Look at this color.
I like it.
That's a rockin' flippin' green right there. Looking good.
That's a Nevada car, right? Yep, Nevada. It's got, still got the chrome T's on it, but I dig the flip. It's looking good. It's pretty sweet right there. Nice job, fella.
Dum da dum 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 dum. Hey! Alright, this one's interesting. So, cruising along, we're in Utah.
We're 31 miles from our next stop for charging.
And I've been using the Enhance Auto Drive for, I don't know, 40% of this drive. And I just went to put it back on again, like this.
And I'm getting a, nope, you can't do it, rest of the drive. I'm not sure what rule I violated, because I've had the max set at 90, but an 80. I had to fight the car once to take control back. Maybe that's why it's mad at me. But yeah, it's mad at me. No more for you!
All right, next stop.
We're heading into Beaver.
Beaver! And the good news is it looks like there's some good food choices on this one. So that will be nice, because I'm a bit hungry.
Here we are. Looks like it's going to be right up here on the left.
Sign. I don't have a stop sign.
But here we are. Pretty big one. And a car wash. You need to get your car washed. Come on and stop at Beaver right next to the Quality Inn. Get a little car wash and get yourself. Oh, 150's there. Car wash and
250's here. Yeah, we're going to do 250. 250 it is. Sold! Super duper windy. And the great smell of, cattle. But we have 250 kilowatts, which is good. And restaurant choices are not so hot. I don't even know if you can hear me right now with this wind. Probably not. I gotta stop this. I am so bad. So bad. I found a Dairy Queen. Yum. Yum. I also got real food, but this is the best part when you're in Utah. When you're in Utah, you get fry sauce for your fries. All right, awkward. Not supposed to do this in vlogs. Fry sauce eating. No, everyone tell me. Ooh, they're hot. Don't eat and vlog. It's a bad no-no. I'm gonna break every rule on this trip. This is the life. Getting a little charge and taking in a blizzard. Butterfinger, that is. Oh yeah. Nice healthy stop here in Beaver. We'll be right back. at the St. George spot, I think the final tab for charging was $25 because I unplugged and then plugged back in another one. And that probably was about 45 minutes to an hour. Here, it's only just over $12. And I went from like 35% to, I'm gonna go to 100. So perhaps the 250 kilowatts is a little bit cheaper because the speed, you're not tying up the charger as long. That's just a guess. If you know the real reason, comment below my beard, right there. Comment right there. Just put, you know the answer, right along the bottom. Chugging along in Utah, southern Utah. Cruising at about 90, we're set at 90. And the best news is, I got out of jail. I'm no longer in enhanced auto assist jail. I'm out! So now I can chill a little bit. We got a long ways to go on this one. This one is a long leg. Long leg here coming up. So South Salt Lake City is where we're gonna charge next. Should be getting there at 4:45, which is 2 hours from now, so this will be the longest leg of the entire trip. This stretch right here. Started the stretch with about 97% battery. We'll see where we land when we get there. It says we're gonna have 21%, but I think we're gonna have less than that because I got a lead foot. Well, it's not really made of lead, but yeah, you get it. Okay, bye. Hello, Salt Lake City. We are just inside Salt Lake right there. Halfway up the Salt Lake. Heading into Draper for our next charge. Beautiful mountains. Wife's hometown, Salt Lake City. We're not gonna lie. This is a long day. We're in, where are we? Draper, Utah. Superchargers, supposed to be 240, but they don't have any signs that say 240. But it looks like it's a 240, it's pretty quick. Very windy drive today. Good thing is it was a tailwind, southwest, but it was a little gusty at times, pushing the car around. Never could open up the windows, but it also never dropped below 85 degrees. It's a hot one. It's 90 degrees here in Draper, Utah. Next stop is Twin Falls, Idaho, I think. Gotta check the map here shortly. I'm lost. Oh, by the way, if you stop at this charger in Draper, you got another Dairy Queen, it looks like. Oh no, Arctic Circle with a play zone for the kids. TJ Maxx, salons, nail salons, Jimmy John's. You cannot hear me, but next to the chargers is a Jamba Juice. Well, this isn't really fun. It's like a massive windstorm that I'm caught in. And it's just blowing around like a lot of dirt. It's just blowing around dirt. Like all this dirt in the middle of the freeway is just getting blown around by this windstorm. And this guy is going off the road right there. Nice. I don't know what he's doing. Oh, the wind took him off the road. Nice. That's a pretty good windstorm up here. Just north of Salt Lake City. On my way. I guess Ogden is next, but look at that. There's like, it's just a dark cloud of dust. Ugh, I'm glad I have a wrap on the car, but it's still curing. I'm not supposed to be taking this much heat. The damage. All right, so we're at our, hopefully our final charging spot. I'm at the Hampton.
One, two, one. 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. Life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again.
Johnny Adams, number 5 from the Sand Trap. Oh, look at that form.
Sally? Looks like we got company.
Oh, yes, Bob. Those look like some hackers right there. Come on, children. Let's get out of here.
Great call, Sally. Let's go, kids. Frickin' golfers. All right, let's crash. Let's crash. No, let's not crash. Let's crunch the numbers now. So total miles on this leg of the trip from Las Vegas through Salt Lake City to Twin Falls was 635.2 miles. Total charges was $49.32. That included the fill up, full battery charge at the Lynx in Las Vegas, which was the end of part one. I think that was $22.72 at that lot. And then we stopped in St. George, Beaver, and Draper. And then all in, $49.32. Before we go, how about this news? I asked for a modest 107 subs. And when we last posted, we asked for 99. We hit it right on the nose. We beat the 107. In fact, we doubled what we asked for. We're at 115. Thank you, everybody, for subbing, subscribing. And I hope you've been enjoying all the bad humor, dad jokes, and copyright violations. It's that time. It's goal time. Is that a pretzel? Oof. Can you cough on a vlog? I know you can't eat, but it's goal time. So what do you say? What do I say? It's goal time. So it's goal time. And the next video is going to come out pretty soon. Probably more aggressive than the last one. So I'm going to say, let's get that sub count to, let's go for 125. Can we get 10 subs before I post part 3? You know what to do. Call the gardener. Do you have a gardener? Call the milkman. You probably don't have a milkman. Just call Aunt Betty. She'll sub. By the way, or not by the way, this is the reminder to tell you that if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. But if you didn't like it, you don't like bad humor, you don't like some Tesla information that's beneficial, some things that aren't, then go ahead. Anyways, that is the end of part 2 of the Tesla road trip. Make sure you tune in for part 3 coming soon. Until next time, this is Tesla. I'm out.